Understand me? And my talk is about dynamic reports with R and LaTeX. And if you have any questions, please do not hesitate to interrupt me or ask afterwards. Okay. So the first question is, I mean, not everybody's a statistician here, so what is R? R is a language that was developed by Becker and Chambers from Bell Labs, I guess in the early 80s. They developed a commercial version of the software and called it, nowadays, S+. So maybe one of you heard this name. And there was also a GNU implementation of the software that was done in 1992 by Ross Ihaka and Robert Gentleman. And currently I'm wondering why there are these symbols inside my talk. I didn't put them there. Okay, that's strange, but well, okay. There are more than 1,000 packages on CRAM, that's the central R repository, so it's pretty much comparable to CTAN, and there are more than 500 project members in the R core team, which does the development on R. It covers all the areas of statistics and data analysis, and I guess it's today the number one tool for open source data analysis. Well, it runs on multiple platforms. I mentioned a few here, Windows, Linux, macOS, etc. And the central homepage is www.r-project.org. So if you ever happen to do some data analysis, have a look at R. Here's a screenshot, one on the Windows version and one from the Emacs version. I mean, Emacs has a very powerful add-on, that's ESS, Emacs Speak Statistics, and there are also various other interfaces for R, for example, for Java, COM, and Python, etc. Okay, you can use R as a simple calculator, however, well, that would not really fit the capacity of the software. I have just here mentioned some of the operators to just give you a brief overview, but well, there are much more things, or many more things, that we can do with R. And very interesting is the way that R deals with data structures. So the standard data structures are these vectors that have a length M, and they consist only of one data type. Then we have matrices that are M times N arrays, also only one data type, and there are the data frames. That's basically a list of objects, and each of these objects may have a different data type, like integer, string, etc. And there are the few lines in the listing to just show how an assignment of numbers to a vector can be done. Okay, here are some other examples, how you can generate vectors and matrices. So there are commands for sequences of vectors or for the replication of certain patterns. That's very powerful. Okay. And here's a small example how you solve a linear model with the power of R. I just define a vector X from 1 to 10. I define a vector Y with some random noise in it. And then I compute a linear model. So it's just a few lines of code, and you get the linear model for a certain data set. And it's also very easy to generate some graphics with R. Here, for example, I give a vector of 1 to 10, and I just say plot. That's basically everything that you need to do to get simple graphics. And now comes the interesting part, where LaTeX comes into play, because R features the concept of certain graphics devices. There are devices for XL11, Windows, Quartz, all kind of PostScript, PDF, etc. There's also a version for PicTech, but I guess that's fairly outdated because I wasn't able to get this to work. And the other one that is mentioned here, that is highlighted in red, is the Tixi device, because there's a graphics device that produces native Tixi code. We'll have a look at this in a second. Okay, this is just an example how you can address these graphics devices. Here, for example, the PDF device that produces native PDF. I just say, well, I want the file to be in C. I define the width and the height of the picture. I say, well, if there are multiple graphics inside the PDF, then I want to have them in one file. And, well, I use the Fong family, I give a title, a PDF version, and define a special paper size. And Then I have again my vector of 1 to 10, say plot, and afterwards I close this PDF device to write the file. Yeah?
Yeah, is there a help file in R that tells you all this?
Yes. There's a. Yeah. Well, the help in R is very extensive. There's a huge HTML-based system, but I agree with you that sometimes the help is not as helpful as it should be. But I guess that's not just on R. That's also with other languages or systems. Okay. So that's the PDF output. And now I want to show you an example of the Tixi output, because that may be really interesting. The Tixi device has its own project homepage. It was written by Charlie Sharpstein and Cameron Bracken, and they also maintain this package, so it's really under development. And the R graphics code is converted to Tixi primitives, which means that you can afterwards easily edit these images if you have to change something. It uses the fonts from the document, and it also allows the math code in captions. And how does it look like? Well, I load the library, Tixi device. I have to install that before. And then I say Tixi. The file should go maybe in a certain tech file. And I want to have a standalone version. So in this way, I generate a file that is embedded directly into other tech documents. If you say standalone is equal to T or true, then it generates a simple standalone file that you can just compile with your favorite LaTeX compiler. Then again, I have my plot command from 1 to 10. I just want to give the vector, and afterwards I close this graphics device. Okay, that's everything. So here's an excerpt from the generated code, which is, even for these just 10 points, much, much longer. So you have all the graphics primitives here. Well, I guess it's much easier to change the R code than changing the Tixi device code, but well, there are maybe certain situations where you really want to edit the Tixi device code. Okay, that was the part about the Tixi device. Now I want to come to the real point of my talk. That's the integration of R and LaTeX by the use of Sweave. Sweave is a package in R that was developed by Friedrich Leisch, who's now at the Ludwig Maximilians University in Munich in Germany. And it's part of the utils package, so it's just part of each R installation. And it works like this, that the LaTeX document contains the tech code and the R code. And the special thing is that the R code is embedded in NoWeb syntax. I have only one line about NoWeb, because I'm pretty sure that there are many people who know much better about this literate programming tool than myself. So, and the tech file is stored, the generated tech file is stored with the NW extension, and it's called in R with Sweave and the file name. And what this Sweave does is it takes out the R code from the document, it runs R on the code, and afterwards generates the graphics, the tables, or whatever has been specified in this file. And afterwards you can run LaTeX or PDF LaTeX on the generated LaTeX file, and you have a document that includes the graphics, the tables, together with the text of your paper. There's also another command, that's the stangle, and it just takes the R code from the document and puts that in a separate file. Okay, so how does it look like? I have a really brief example here. As you can see, I use the SCR article class, and I specify my title and the author, and then comes these double smaller signs and the double greater signs with an equal, and I just say 1 plus 1. And the code is then finished by using the at. And that's all. So when I edit this in R and I run Sweave on this document, what I get is a small LaTeX document which looks like the following. We have our standard command, and then there are these S chunk, S input, and S output commands, which are just wrappers for verbatim environments. So if one wants to hook into this to maybe use the listing package or something else, then it should be not so difficult. And what do we get when we compile this document? Well, we get a small document which just specifies 1 plus 1 and the result. So that's fairly simple. So within those brackets, you can specify many variables which tell R how to deal with the stuff that is inside these brackets. We can suppress the R code. We can suppress the results. A combination of both might not seem very useful, but however, I can show you an example that, for example, when you just load the data, you don't want to see the R code and you don't want to see the result, so you just want it done. So then, well, if we specify results equal to tech, then this is suppresses the verbatim output. This is especially useful when you have R code that generates for tech code directly. There's a package in R which is called xtable, and it generates tables directly in the LaTeX layout, where there's an option to create PDF versions of pictures in case I want to have pictures. There's also the respective EPS command, and I can specify the width and the height of images. And there's also a command sweave opts that sets options globally. And I can also address certain parts of the R code using this name command, and I can access these parts. So in just in case you have a larger data analysis, that might be really useful. Okay, so if I have a scalar result, there's also the sexpr command that is useful when you want to have inside your document a result from R. The only condition that is necessary is that the R return value must be a string, or it must be convertible into a string. And I can show you an example in a second. So here's a really large example, or a bigger example, and since I guess nobody except me can read that, I will go into the details in the next slide. So in the first part, I just load the data set. That's the iris data set from machine learning, and I then want to have the dimensions of the data set. I just say sexpression, number of columns of the iris data, and the number of rows of the data set. So that's the first hint on how I get an overview of my data. In the next chunk, I want to have the output summary statistics for the data variable petal length. And in the next, I just say, well, I also don't want the R code itself. I just want to have the results. And I specify results is equal to tech, because I know that the xtable command just generates me a table in LaTeX format. And I define a caption for this table, and that's it. And the final code chunk, that's a figure. So I specify the standard commands for a float here, and then I specify figure is equal to true. So I tell LaTeX, well, the stuff that R does here is generate a picture. And in the background, when I run this code, the respective PDF file or EPS file is generated. That's just the end of the document. And what is generated afterwards from this code? I guess it's not very visible, but you can see here in the first part, that's the dimensions of the data set just in the text. Then we have the summary statistics in the second part, the table which was generated by xtable, and finally the graphics. So I guess that's fairly nice, and because you have the R code and the deck document of your paper in just a single document. Because during my time at university, it sometimes happened that, well, the graphics did not match the text and so on. So that's very, very dangerous. Okay, I prepared a second example, which also shows some of the capabilities that R can do, because in preparation of this trip, I was interested in the exchange rate euro-dollar, and well, during the last weeks, it was not so happy to check this, but well, what can we do? Okay, the interesting stuff is here in the first part. Let me just indicate that. I also extracted that on the next slide, because what I do here is I use the system command from R to get the data, the current data with VGET from the European Central Bank that specifies a CSV file or an XML file, and then in zip. And afterwards, I use the R internal zip command to extract the data. So whenever I run this document from R, it always takes the latest version of the exchange rates and compiles them. Yeah?
A question. if I run it several times, LATEX documents I need to run several times to get labels right, will it always repeat this get command?
In principle, yes. In reality, no, because when you run the document twice or three times through LaTeX, not through Sweave, because after the testcode, after the testcode has been generated, of course R is not necessary anymore. But just when you change the R commands or the test document, and what we get here afterwards is just a data set which indicates the exchange rates for, I guess from. I cannot read it by myself, but I guess it was the beginning of the 90s. And, well, the latest data set was 135. Well, that was long time ago, unfortunately. Okay. I have a few literature remarks. If you want to know something about R, then you find a lot of really good books. And I also find a good book in the bookstore just across the street. And if there are any questions, just please ask me. And I'm done.
What's an example of a string, of a result that's not convertible?
I guess a matrix. If you return a real big matrix, it makes no sense to put that in one string. So I would just use it for the number of columns and something like that, or for summary statistics like mean, median, etc.
Also, the top level domain on the European Central Bank is INT. What's that?
International, I guess.
Forgive me. So first, can we thank the speaker? Can I remind folks about the microphone that if you want to ask questions?
Thank you. Two questions. First question. When you generate plots with Sweave, is it possible to put tech code on the labels, like in the title, some thing?
Yeah,
I can put just directly tech code.
Yeah, I guess so. I would need to check it, but I guess R understands the tech syntax. I would really need to dig into it deeper.
And second question, is it possible when I, for example, when I tweak the wording of the document, is it possible to Sweave to tell it not to run R again, just take it from the previous run and generate, and then is it possible to switch on and off the R run?
Well, you mean you just want to run LaTeX again?
No, I want to change my master document.
Yeah?
Just wording, not the R code. And then generate new LaTeX document and again run it. So I don't want to. So I did not change R code, so I don't want to rerun. Is it possible to say?
Well, I guess not, because the text file is generated only from the R code, or
from the master,
and from the master document.
Yeah. And okay. Thank you.
Who competes with R?
SPSS. S plus, MATLAB, Minitab, Octave, Mathematica, etc.
What are the virtues of R compared to those systems?
In comparison with?
Some of those.
Well, it's free.
Could I comment on that?
Yeah, sure.
Back in the late 1970s, early 1980s, some people at Bell Labs, the same folks who brought you Unix and all of that other great stuff, developed a language called S. And this later got improved and became S+. There's no S++, for those of you who would like to have something. And that's a commercial product which is available. It's been bought by another company, but the executable is still called S+. R is essentially a complete free re-implementation of S+. There are several textbooks that you can use for training students that use both of those interchangeably. There are slight differences between them, as always happens, but by and large, you can write code that will work in both. And the beauty of R is that it has an extremely active development group. There are thousands of packages available for it.
Yep.
It has binary distributions for a number of platforms. For many platforms, it's relatively easy to build the code. And really, I think for many people in the field of statistics, it is going to be the common system they use.
Mm. I guess there are also many packages in the area of biostatistics where it's really, really active.
Yes. One other thing, there is a complete bibliography of books and other publications about S+ and R in the Tug Bibliography Archive at Utah.
Just a quick comment. I think Rick Becker, who was listed on R, was one of the developers of S, and I didn't even know he had done R. He was actually the shortstop of my softball team at Bell Labs. But so it's the same guy. It's the same.
Yeah.
I'm Dennis. To answer Boris's question about graphics, R has an incredible graphics control built into it, and I use it quite a bit. And you know, it's actually easier to use the R documentation than LaTeX documentation to adjust your figures.
Just to further on the use of R, in Denmark, the largest sales modeling agency uses R as their primary product because it's very snappy at doing time series analysis and forecasting. And much, much cheaper than using SAS. And it's easier to get help with R than it is to get help about SAS.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. I just had another question back for Dennis on the graphic stuff. I guess I don't need to do this in front of everybody. But Boris's question was if you can get LaTeX labels inside the graphic, or if you could put an equation like in your figure or something like that.
You probably could, but the labeling inside of R is well done. That I don't know. There is an R conference coming up in July at NIST, but if you didn't register by June 20th, you can't get in. Please do. Thank you.